What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? I am at my next service call. I'm gonna put this. Put this right there. Oh man. Everything's falling down today, I swear. I can't win. I literally can't win. I left my tool bag at a job. Don't even ask, but I left my tool bag at a job and I gotta use this one that I took from the shop. So nonetheless, everything's falling apart today. I have a Jandy JXI 400, and this is a 400,000 B2 natural gas pool heater. We got a lot of growth around the unit. Customer's complaint is that we are getting no heat, and he saw an ignition failure there. So right now we have a check flow. Let's go into service mode here. Okay, we'll turn our filter pump on. That will ramp up the filter pump right there. A lot of overgrowth here. Let's see if we can verify the customer's complaint. So the first thing, once the pressure switch closed, sensing water flow, our inducer assembly, our blower, this is so annoying, our blower motor kicked on. And that's a good sign. I'm also checking around the base, make sure there's no leaks coming from the heater. I'm waiting for that click of the gas valve opening. There's the click of the gas valve, and I can get a nice good whiff of gas coming out of our draft assembly, the draft hood. So that means I get my gas valves opening, I have good gas flow, but we're not getting ignition. So let's turn this back off again, and I'm gonna show you guys how I heater, how I troubleshoot and diagnose a Jandy pool heater. Now, since it's an established heater, I'm not gonna go into the main board, but I am going to remove the four screws, two on the right and two on the left, that hold the top piece, the top panel, this whole box, the top of the heater. So I'm gonna do the two on the left-hand side, and we already got that, and we'll pull that off. Okay, there's gonna be a control wire and a ground wire. That's just usually long enough so it's, I can get it out of the way. Okay, everything's here. Nothing out of the ordinary. Everything's pretty much typical here. All right, this is our hot surface igniter. We're gonna remove the two wires from there, and we're gonna ohm out the hot surface igniter and see if we have good resistance there. Yeah, we got a bad hot surface igniter, 1000%. Look at that. That should be in the 50s to 100 range of resistance, but we're getting -2. So we're gonna use a pair of socket set. Take those two bolts out of there, nuts, and pull out the hot surface igniter. No bueno. No good, Mr. George. No good. So if you want to look closely at that hot surface igniter, we have a little fracture right there. No bueno. No bueno. All right, here's that new hot surface igniter. It's an identical replacement. I'm ohming it out, brand new out of the box. I'm getting 50 on the dot. Look at that. Perfect. So it comes with some new hardware. We're going to mount this on the inside of the unit, fire up. Now, one of the things to keep in mind when handling the hot surface igniter, you don't want to touch the tip, right? That dark gray, almost black material, that's actually the hot surface igniter itself. You do not want to touch that with your fingers or hands. And be very careful. Don't drop it. It's going to break, and then you're going to be mad. So I got a new gasket there installed, and I'm going to line this up there
and fire up.
All right, she is now secure. The leads don't matter, the two wires, doesn't matter where you put them back. It's not polarity specific. I'm gonna get my vacuum and just vacuum out the rest of this garbage that's in here. All right, inside of the unit is clean. Now, speaking of polarity real quick, if you're installing a 110 volt model, now these come configured factory for 220 volt, 240 volt. You can flip the power inverter card over and wire for 110 volts, 110, 120. However, keep in mind, if you reverse polarity on your field control, your field installed line voltage wiring, you're gonna get ignition failure right out of the box. Just flip your polarity L1 and your neutral, and you'll be good to go. All right, let's put the cover back on, fire up. That clicking sound you're hearing, that's the VersaFlo, which is right there. That's Jandy's proprietary valve that when the heater is not heating, water, pool water is not flowing through it, extending the life of the heat exchanger. It's awesome. One of the reasons why my company installs Jandy JXI heaters is specifically for that reason. You'll prolong the heater if pool water is not passing through it 24/7. Why do you need to force water through a heat exchanger, through the pool heater? You know, especially with the, no one's really on top of chemicals that much sometimes. You let your water balance, your water chemistry become unbalanced, you kill your heat exchanger, and the thing lasts 2-3 years and people complaining. So Jandy has the VersaFlo option on their pool heaters. You can add that on as well if you don't, if you didn't buy it factory that way. Just food for thought. All right, we have an 82 degree water temperature. I have my pool set point set for 90. I am still running in service mode, and there's a click of the gas valve, and Houston, we have ignition.
Beautiful.
Now we're cooking with gas.
Awesome.